Welcome to Leaders Connect. Leaders Connect is started with a specific objective of creating 1,000 plus leaders, where all the working professionals and business people share their real-time challenges on our website, www.themassleadership.com. We see all challenges, filter them. And every week on Wednesday, we invite top management leaders from corporate company who will be giving solutions for our real-time challenges on leadership. That's when we call it as Leaders Create More Leaders.
Leaders are finding challenges. Now, a couple of leaders from different organizations are here. In fact, one of our members from Mr. Devarayan, who is the HR from ABB Hitachi. So he's here.
When we are talking about innovations, like, you know, the failures are a byproduct or the byproducts, right? Like, you know, morning I was listening to one of the speaker in industry and commerce. He says that the industry is now in a cutthroat position. The margins are very less. The competitions are very high. You know, your margins are becoming very, very thin, thinner and thinner. So because of the competition and in this competitive world of margin getting less and all this stuff. So that innovations, like, you know, innovations are, like, you know, bound to be failed, and that the organizations has to bear that failures. So how do you see that, you know, that the innovations will be implemented in those smaller, middle and, you know, smaller organizations?
Yeah, no, I think, so there are all kinds of innovations, right? The innovations do not always have to be expensive. Like, a company like Microsoft betting a big bet on creating a quantum computing is a $1 billion innovation investment, risk carrying. But I can also do an innovation in my team where the team is saying, for me, the right way to work is not on meetings, but I prefer offline communication where everybody can collaborate together. And my ability to reach to a constructive point of view is way better because I'm going to contribute to that point of view in my most productive time rather than the time you are forcing on me to be on a call in a sync time, which suits you. So that is also an innovation, right? So you will have to take your bets. There are some innovations which are not so risky, and even if they fail, you really don't lose out a lot, but they practice your brain muscle. They practice the culture in the org to say innovating and failing is good thing. And you need to keep nurturing that always. And then as a leader, you have to apply a big bet. Eventually, it's going to be a ROI conversation with your own leadership, right? So at the end of the day, you have to say, this is an idea. I want to attempt it. This is the fund that I need. The risk of failing is 50%, 60%, but the risk of getting successful is a paradigm shift in my business. So I bring in so much more revenue for the next year or the year after. And eventually a leader will have to take that call. Now, every business, whatever the margin be, right, will have to take those few bets. Otherwise, if you just keep doing margin every quarter, eventually you will become irrelevant. It's race to the bottom, right? Eventually you will land at the bottom. So the idea is, as a leader, are we having enough insight and oversight on what our teams are saying from grounds up to pick those right bets and create a business construct around that to say, where does this bet land me? And against that, what is that I'm asking the organization to invest on? What is the flip side? And then you have some kind of risk mitigation plan, right? If this fails, does that whole investment is up in the air, or you are saying partially you will recover it in certain ways, so on and so forth. So there is a lot of diligence that we can apply as a leader. But I think eventually, as you start showing the results with smaller ideas, you build your credibility as a leader within the org, that you have demonstrated picking up on few ideas and delivering to a success that enhances your chances of getting that big bet betted on your idea rather than somebody else.
Yeah, nicely put up, Shalaka. Actually, like, you know, it is just for all the community I have asked this question. So anyway, the other thing is, like, you know, the change is inherent, and the pace of the change is also, like, you know, it is very, very high, the pace of the change, and it's changing very fast, and without the innovation, your existence will be questioned also. So
yes,
it's true that we have to innovate, bring up the innovative culture in the organization. Thanks, yes, Shalaka, for that.